here that the brothers are having, that when some Muslims make takfir on other Muslim countries because of a major sin. Like the brother mentioned, is the way of the Khawarij is true. It's a major sin, no doubt, and there's no justification for it. There's no justification for it.
Does it make that country a Muslim country?
Yeah, it's a Muslim, but it's falling to Masiyah. Like even now, if a Muslim, you know now, majority of Muslims in Britain, or some Muslims, I'll say some Muslims, are involved in interest. You know, they, and guess who gave the fatwa? Qardawi. What do you think about Qardawi?
I don't like him.
Yeah, Qardawi gave the fatwa. Qardawi, he said out of necessity, but now, especially among the Asian community, our brothers, they took that fatwa as if wahi from Allah. So they, honestly, what it means, honestly means that you have nowhere to stay. And there's no way for you to get, but in this country we know that you can, especially if you have a family, no way you're going to be staying outside. They will give you a house. Even they will help, even as a single person, they will give you a place to stay. So the fatwa of Qardawi, there's no fatwa of Sheikh Ibn Baz, alhamdulillah, there's no fatwa of the ulama of Saudi. So my point here is that they're doing is a major sin. If a Muslim does a major sin, does not take him out for Islam.
Okay.
Except he believes halal.
Okay. Another thing. Yeah. In 1990.
Yeah.
Rais al-Istikhbarat, you know, the Turki al-Faisal.
Yeah.
He went to Syria. And yeah. He sat down with the Iranians.
Okay.
Yeah. And the Syrian to topple Saddam. What do you think about that?
To topple Saddam.
Overthrow Saddam. Yeah.
Okay. So, where did you get that from, by the way?
Firstly.
Yeah. Firstly, this subject will not benefit us as an ummah. It will not benefit us. Okay, now imagine, I know for the sake of argument, I know Turki Faisal, like you claim, he went to Syria and he wants to get rid of Saddam.
With the Iranian.
Let us, for the sake of argument, say that happened. It's not true. How that will benefit a Muslim how to pray?
I'll tell you how it benefits a Muslim how to pray.
Yeah.
Yani 4 million Iraqi died.
Okay, Muslim, 4 million. Okay, wait, step by step. How is that going to pray?
How's that going to stop me going to the Muslim?
You care about Muslim Ummah.
The people who died in Iraq is that my brother and my sisters.
Yeah, but British court killed them. The American killed them. No, that's Saudi.
So they launched
2003. The British and the America, Bush and Blair, lied. And they went to Iraq and they shot Iraq. Step by step. No,
it is.
Saudi was against it. 2003, Saudi was against it. It's ma'roof, akhi. United Nations, Saudi was against it. Again, I'm saying Saudi. You're changing the topic now. Again,
Saudi.
Step by step. Okay.
No, I know history. I know history better than you.
2003.
Look.
Let's go back to tarikh, to history. Which people start speaking about the mistakes of the hukam? How it started? How? Let's go back to history to see who is following the Quran and the Sunnah here and who's following a deviated sect that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam
against. Saudi.
No, I'm not Saudi. Muhammad
is not following the Sunnah.
Muhammad, I'm not talking about Saudi, brother. Muhammad, you have married some Saudi or ish? Huh? I'm not talking about Saudi. I'm talking history. Okay, let me go back to history. That Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, as we mentioned, as Bukhari and Muslim. Yes, when Hudayfa ibn al-Yaman, he said to him, he said, O Messenger of Allah, he said, if there will be leaders, he's talking about leaders, and he said they will have a body of human, but the heart of a Satan, the heart of a Satan. And the Prophet Muhammad advised to hear and obey. Not as a justification for their oppression, because when you rebel, it's not going to bring any good or benefits. But let us go back to history. The people that start talking about the hukam, the leaders openly, and mention their mistakes, it was the time of Uthman ibn Affan. It was Abdullah ibn radiallahu anhu wa ardah. Abdullah ibn Saba' al-Himyari, he was a double-sided man. He was a Rafidi, started Shi'ism, and started Khawarij again. He started going to Egypt, he started going to Iraq, and he said, Uthman said this. Uthman said that. Look what Uthman is doing. Uthman is removing the Umara and bringing the other Umara from his family. So what that caused? That caused the people to rebel against Uthman bin Affan, radiallahu anhu wa arda. That's why, as Bukhari mentioned, when the people came to Usama bin Zayd, Usama bin Zayd bin Haritha, they said to him, don't you advise Uthman? They asked Usama, don't you advise Uthman? He said, I do, but I'm not gonna be the first person to start a fitna. I don't have to tell you if I advise him or not. So my brother, may Allah bless you, Akhi Muhammad. Our way is the haram that is happening in Saudi or Algeria or Morocco, we are against it. But how to deal with it? We go back to Quran and Sunnah. Syria, what happened in Syria, Akhi?
No, Bashar al-Assad kafir.
No doubt about that. What were you doing that? He's kafir. Okay, how the country become better?
Huh?
How the country become better?
It will, inshallah, it will.
No, brother. Serious.
You have to do khuruj on that guy, kafir.
No, but no, with ability. No, Muhammad. Even if it's kafir.
You allowed to kafir somebody?
No, it's kafir. That guy's kafir.
How many refugees are there?
Step by step, yeah. Yeah, it's bad.
Taking
Okay. He mentioned Syria. One second.
Yeah, Syria, yeah.
The ambassador of
Saudi.
Russia said, I'm going to tell you another time. The ambassador of Russia, he said, if United Arab Emirates did not supply us with jet fuel, we would not even do one
ghara.
Shu ghara bil
English? One attack, one strike.
Okay.
Raid, yeah?
Raid.
Ghara, raid, yeah. It's a raid, yeah. That's true, it's a raid.
Yeah? So if the Russian ambassador, he will say that, it means true.
No, how? Allah says, Allah يقول, إِن جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَئٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا فَكَيْفَ إِذَا كَانَ بِالْكَافِرِ
لا. أنا تبي الصراحة. Another thing. Yeah? Another thing.
إذا كان ضد الإمارات, he must be truthful. إذا كان ضد him, he must. No, but he's a kafir. Anyway, brother, look, what I'm saying to you, Muhammad, yeah? I see you with the other, Umar, yeah? You know what's happening now?
I work for myself.
No, I'm not saying you're working for him. They say you work for him. But ask, we work for Allah. Alhamdulillah.
Inshallah.
Ta'ala. What I'm saying to you, Muhammad, now, okay, what I can do easily, I can stand for the camera. الحكام كفارة فاجرة زنادقة اخرجوا عليهم ثم يذهب إلى ستاربكس بسم الله أنا يقتلوا بعدهم بعد أكد إيزلي نحن العرب خاصة العرب نحب العاطفة بالعاطفة تهز العرب كلهم لكن لابد إيش لابد العقل يا أخي لابد الشرع قبل ذلك النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام he came to people they were worshiping idols in the Kaaba they were doing zina openly prostitute house openly النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام يقول للصحابة الحرب there's no قوة to الصحابة
okay.
وهي تيج them be patient فاصبر كما صبر no we go back to the أصل no مهند we go back to the أصل we have to teach the people you understand أخي my point is listen to مهند what we say to you أخي why we have this problem do you know why because not just the حكام
it's the حكام it's the first
only the حكام
no and the people also
بارك الله فيك حكام الحكومين حكام they're not free from the mistakes and so on likewise the حكومين بأخي الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned the Quran gave us the cure لينصرن الله من ينصره إن الله لقوي عزيز كيف ننصر الله بطاعة الله وطاعة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام
ابتعاد عن العمالة مع الغرب
لا
لا الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم تعامل مع اليهود ويقول يد الله مغلولة
دقيقة
عملة بالأديان
بس سؤال
عملة طيبة الحلال هل تعتقد
السلام مع الكيان الصهيوني حلال أم حرام
السلام أولا حلال السلام معهم حلال لماذا أقول لك لماذا النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام كتب السلام